Before we get started actually dissecting the eye, we're going to go over some of the basic tools you need to get the job done. These tools I'm using are all pulled out of a basic dissecting kit, so they should be fairly common. The first tool we're going to use is the blunt probe, and the blunt probe is really good, especially for eye dissections, because you don't risk damaging any of the structures while you're pointing or moving things around. Second, most important cutting tool are scissors. We're going to be using these a lot to get into the interior of the eye. And I'm also wearing gloves, which is something you should be wearing anytime you perform a dissection. A last optional tool that I'm going to be utilizing a few times during the video is a scalpel. Scalpels usually come as a handle and a packaged blade. You can get various size blades. Make sure the size you're using is appropriate for what you want to do. If you haven't used a scalpel before, I'm going to go through quickly how to put the blade onto the handle. It's important to be very careful when doing this. To open the package, it should be clearly marked which end you should start peeling. You're going to want to expose the base of the blade and keep the package still covering the sharp part in order to protect your hands. Once you have the base of the blade exposed, take a look at the slant on the blade, match it up with the slant on the handle, and you're going to want to slide the scalpel handle into the blade until it locks in place. Once the blade is secure, you can remove the rest of the wrapper and set the scalpel aside. Once your tools and your work surface are ready, the next step is to prepare the eye for dissection. The better job you do preparing the eye for dissection, the easier job you'll have finding structures and exploring the internal anatomy of the eye later. The first thing you should do once you get the eye out of its packaging and onto the dissection mat is to take a look at the external structures of the eye. You'll notice a band of muscle along the outside. This is the remnants of the muscle that's actually used to move the eye within the socket. You should also see the cornea. And the cornea should be cloudy as a result of the preservative. You'll also see the fairly thick layer of fat that surrounds the eye as well. Step one in preparing the eye is to begin removing any of the extra fat around the eye, and you can start doing this with your blunt probe. Some of the larger pieces should be fairly easy to pull off on your own. Once you get some of the pieces loose, you're going to want to move ahead to your scissors. And there's going to be a lot of cutting involved to get all of the extra tissue out from around the outside of the eye. Removing the fat and preparing the exterior surface of the eye can take several minutes, so we are going to speed things up a bit here so you can see the entire process in a shorter amount of time. One thing to keep in mind while you're removing the extra tissue from the outside of the eye is the optic nerve. Make sure you don't damage this with your scissors or your blunt probe. At this point, the eye is almost ready for dissection. If there's any remaining fat around the optic nerve, try to trim as much of that away as possible. It'll make it easier to locate the nerve later after we've begun the dissection.